strategy. So, overall audit strategy sets the scope, timing and direction of audit and ultimately leading to audit plan. So, scope, timing, direction of audit and a detailed audit plan. So, four things are required. You must know what to do in audit, to do list of audit. You must know the timing, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months. Outcome is the direction. And for that, strategy is to make plan. Now, what is audit strategy? To understand audit strategy, you must use the resource to deploy for specific audit areas, such as use of appropriately experienced team member for high risk area or involvement of experts for complex matters. So, in every audit, as a strategist, there are routine works and there are complex tasks. Routine work may be given to the junior staff and complex task is given to experts. So, resource allocation for audit strategy is very, very important. Now, the amount of resources to be allocated for different audit areas, like number of team members to observe the inventory count at material location, review of other auditors' work in case of group audit, audit budget in hours to high risky area, these things are required. So, three things come. One, in case of resource allocation, you must see the complexity and time required. In case the review of the work of other auditor is required, in case of group audit, the more time must be allocated to high risk area. Now, when these resources are to be deployed, such as whether an interim audit stage or at key cutoff dates, you have to see how such resources are managed, directed and supervised, such as when team briefing and debriefing meeting takes place, how engagement partner and manager review are expected to take place within the site and off-site, and whether to complete engagement quality control review. So, audit strategy looks and they aim to supervise through meeting, where briefing and debriefing of the work is being done by engagement partner and their managers to see the quality work is done or not. Take one case. Suppose you are provided audit of a government department making steel. हाँ सब उड़ गया क्या?
हमने सर क्या किया था?
सो लेट्स थिंक दिस वे, यू हैव अ केस You are auditor of a steel making public limited company. So when you go to do the audit and as the engagement partner, it is your job to create a business strategy where audit will be done properly. So there will be routine task and there will be complex task. If it is a routine task, give it to junior staff. If it is a complex task, give it to the expert. Now, next thing will be resource to be allocated for a specific audit area. You have to see that inventory count at material location must be proper. In case of review of other auditors' work, in case of group audit, audit budget in hours to allocate high risk area. So this point suggests that as an auditor for that steel company, high risk area must give higher time. So high risk area HRA must get more time. And here experts must be involved. Now, when these resources are to be deployed, such as whether at interim audit stage or key cutoff dates, then we must see how such resources are managed, directed, and supervised. When briefing and debriefing meetings are held, where engagement partner and manager reviews the work at site and off site, as per the quality control norms. So, in case of this steel audit, there may be three locations, 1, 2, 3. Here there will be two team members, here there will be three team members, and here there will be four team members. So, when the debriefing meeting takes place or briefing meeting takes place on the site or at other place which is off-site, quality control review will be done by manager and it will be checked by the engagement partner. So this is how the audit strategy should be evolved. It should be properly mapped. So for location 1, for location 2, location 3, it must be properly coordinated as a good audit strategy in the interest of organization and in benefit of the auditing firm. So, as a faculty, I have certain observations to make. Number one, audit strategy has two purposes. Resource allocation and monitoring. In case of resource allocation, simpler task and complex task, this will go to expert this will go to junior staff. In case of monitoring, there will be briefing and debriefing. Monitoring can take place on site and off site. In this debriefing and briefing meeting, the manager reviews, which is further reviewed by engagement partner, the strategy can be modified further. So this is what is the observation as a faculty I am going to make. The faculty observation tells you the flow of movement of the thing, where in the exam you will be asked a scenario, a case study, and you will be required to answer like this. So I hope you have understood and you will write your answer according to the way I have explained to you. Now, what is the relationship between an overall audit strategy and audit plan? This particular point has been asked many times in your old examination paper, either as a direct question or as a short note question or even as a small case. So examination has asked this particular point as a case, as short notes, as a direct question. Once an overall strategy has been established, an audit plan can be developed to address various matters identified. In overall audit strategy, taking in account the need to achieve audit objective through efficient use of auditors' resources. So it says, when audit strategy, which is defined for various matters, matter 1, matter 2, matter 3 and matter 4, based on audit objective, so let me write it properly. Audit objective. This means the aim of such audit. The establishment of overall audit strategy and detailed audit plan are not necessarily discrete or sequential process, but are interrelated, since change in one may result change in other. So take one case. In overall audit strategy, which I write OAS, two changes happen. Number one, stock audit is introduced. Number two, waste loss is added. Now, in the audit plan, you will have certain changes to cover point 1 and 2. So, change in one causes change in other. They say audit planning is a continuous process. Continuous is a very, very big word. It is, they say, an iterative process which happens on a regular basis and often begins shortly after or in connection with completion of the previous audit and continues till completion of the current audit engagement. So, what was started as an audit in 2017 will follow in 2018, and what has happened in 2017 will happen on the basis of details given in 2016. So, it is a continuous process and it includes timing of certain activities and audit procedure that needs to be completed prior to performance of further audit procedure. So, planning includes the need to consider prior to audit identification and assessment of work of misstatement. Items like what will be the analytical procedure, understanding legal and regulatory framework, determination of materiality, involvement of expert and risk assessment. So, you have to see that it starts with analytical procedure, looks into legal framework, then it considers materiality and expert involvement, and finally the risk assessment. So, this is how things move in a proper way. So, my dear friend, audit planning is a continuous activity and it continues on a regular basis. And as an auditor, you have to always consider that it is an ongoing activity as long as that business continues further. So, my observation is that audit of previous year data is not only on such data but on policies, framework decided in previous period of prior years, and it considers analysis to be basis based on data available, risk involved, involvement of experts. So, these things are required to be seen in a total perspective. As a faculty, I feel that it is a continuous exercise. And it must be done on a regular basis, and the observations of audit has to be considered for the past data. The past observation must be taken into consideration and it must be fulfilled as per the requirement of the business. And